Hi, welcome to Enchiridion. With a body shaped like that of a modern salamander, the amphibian Diplocaulus had an unusual triangular shaped head. The wings on either side of its head might have streamlined its shape, helping it to glide through the water. They might have been a safety feature, making it hard for predators to swallow Diplocaulus. Also, because they made the head seem large, this might have frightened some predators away. It was a Lepospondyl amphibian with a distinctive boomerang-shaped skull. Lepospondyls include species with newt-like, eel or snake-like, and lizard-like forms. Various species were aquatic, semiaquatic, or terrestrial. The largest of all Lepospondyls was Diplocaulus, up to a meter in length, but most were much smaller. They were a diverse taxon of reptiliomorph tetrapods that lived from the Early Carboniferous to the Early Permian, with the exception of the Diplocaulus minimus, a Lepospondyl of the Late Permian of Morocco. And they were geographically restricted to what is now Europe and North America. Five major groups of Lepospondyls are known: Adelospondyli, Aistopoda, Lysorophia, Microsauria, and Nectridea, a diverse group of interesting, typically small creatures. The unusual boomerang-shaped head of the Diplocaulus has been a source of interest ever since its discovery. The two main theories include that it made it impossible for other predators to swallow, a defense mechanism, or that it functioned as a hydrofoil, allowing it to move in strong currents. If this theory is true, it would be able to more easily control how water flows over its head. They also conducted experiments, and the results indicated that the horns generated significant lift, which would have allowed the animal to rise in the water column of a river or stream quite quickly and with great ease. This indicates that the Diplocaulus would not have been seriously disadvantaged if they chose to attack prey items while rising through the water. It may also have been a form of recognition between the members of the same species, but the two previous theories are the most probable ones, as they include adaptations dictated by evolutionary pressures. Most studies have argued that an eel-like tail movement or anguilliform movement was the main force of locomotion used by the Diplocaulus and its relatives. Diplocaulus means double stalk or double call, due to its distinctive head that looks like a boomerang. It was named by renowned paleontologist Edward Drinker Cope in 1877. Species include D. salamandroides and D. magnicornis, D. breberostris, D. recurbatus, and D. minimus. And there are also dubious species like D. lambatus, D. copi, D. pacillus, D. primiginius, and D. parvus. Diplocaulus was probably a piscivore that ate insects and fish. Like all amphibians, it had to live near the water due to the fact that amphibian eggs have no shells and must be laid in the water or they will dry out and die. It was a relatively large Lepospondyl amphibian, reaching around 3 feet and 3 inches in length. It weighed as much as a cat, around 5 to 10 pounds. It has been discovered in North America and Africa. It lived during the Late Carboniferous to Permian 270 million years ago, long before the dinosaurs evolved. And fossil representation includes a trio of three juvenile Diplocaulus in a burrow of 8 along with a juvenile Oryops, which were found to have been partially eaten by the sailback synapsid Dimetrodon, which likely unearthed the amphibians during a drought. One of the three was killed with a bite to the head, taking part of its skull and portions of the brain, a fatal injury that the animal couldn't defend against. And with that, thank you for watching this program episode of Prehistoric Beasts as a short, fact-based episode. This is Enchiridion. See you next time.